second season, which begins today, the season, holy season of Lent. And it is a season of grace, where we bring our lives before the Lord Jesus, our Savior, our Redeemer, and ask Him to purify our hearts, to cleanse our hearts, to give us His grace, to remove those sinful attitudes, sinful behaviors, sins that still may be lurking and dwelling in our hearts, and to remove all obstacles to our response to His grace. To remove those sinful attitudes, sinful behaviors, sins that still may be lurking and dwelling in our hearts, and to remove all obstacles to our response to His grace. It's like for the next 6 weeks of Lent, the Lord is giving us this spiritual retreat, where He is taking us on this journey of interior conversion, interior renewal, to change our hearts. And each one of us, no doubt, does have some areas that are in need of improvement, spiritual improvement, some areas where possibly we have failed the Lord miserably and are in need of a corrective action, which is what the season of Lent is all about, responding to the Lord's grace, turning away from sin, to embrace the Lord's compassion, His love, and His mercy. So don't get discouraged that it's so long, 6 weeks, because you can do it. 6 weeks is not that long. If you look on it as a retreat every day, walking with the Lord and listening to Him and doing your spiritual exercises to come to the celebration of Easter. Every day, walking with the Lord and listening to Him and doing your spiritual exercises to come to the celebration of Easter. And as with any new beginning, of course, there is a sense of encouragement and optimism and an attitude of eagerness, ready to get started. And that's what Lent is. We're making a new beginning, starting a retreat, a new season of grace with the Lord. So we approach with that attitude, as we are sorry for our sins, but also eager to let the Lord purify us, cleanse us. It is not only an interior journey where we ask the Lord to cleanse our hearts, change our hearts, help us with His grace to turn away from sin, but there is also, of course, the external component too, where what evidence do we give by our external behavior, our external attitude, that in fact a conversion has taken place in our heart. And that's where the idea, of course, of works of mercy comes in, works of charity, almsgiving, which we hear mentioned in today's reading from the Gospel, but merciful actions towards our neighbor, towards the poor, towards the sick. So all of this, of course, as we do the interior journey, is meant to also lead to the formal confession of our sins in the sacrament of penance, sometime during the season of Lent, to formally ask through the sacramental grace of the sacrament for the forgiveness and the absolution of our sins, really, with the Lord's grace, cleansing the soul, cleaning out the house, so that we're making that fresh beginning that He wishes of us during this beautiful season of grace. The threshold today of a new season of grace and the ashes that we receive on our forehead is an external sign of the interior journey of conversion that we propose to undertake this season, with the help of the Lord, with the help of His all-powerful,